Hi, it's Vicky here and welcome back to another card making video. Today I'm going to play with my alcohol markers and there is a new set by Altenew that has just been released. This is the set D and it contains 12 markers. If you are not familiar with these markers, these are alcohol markers, which means that they blend beautifully together. There are other sets available already, but this is a great addition in your collection. Now, the fun thing is that they give you 4 markers that you know they match perfectly for blending. So in this set, you get 3 color families, the purples. You also get these blue-green ones and also the browns. Also keep in mind that these markers are refillable and there are also available nibs if you feel that the nib of your marker needs changing. The barrels are triangular, which means that they will not roll on your table. On both of the cups you get the color as well as the number. And there is a little ring that you can use to distinguish which nib is which. So you get a fine tip one and a brush on the other side. This brush is really lovely and these markers are actually a great alternative to Copics if you don't want to invest on such an expensive product. Now I am quickly swatching them for you so you can see the real colors. I'm working on Nina Solar White cardstock. I also like to store them in the plastic case they come with. I find that you can fit 4 of them in a row and you always know which markers go with which one. And I'm swatching them so you can see the real colors, since in the packaging they tend to have the colors more vibrant, so you can see the difference here. Now the fun thing about the alcohol markers by Altenew is that they come at the same colors as their ink pads. So if you are familiar with their oval sets, you will see that the 4 inks in the oval set come as markers as well, which means that you can do lots of things in terms of design, which is exactly what I'm going to show you today. Now I'm going to use these colors today to color a flower and I'm using a new stamp set that has been released for February. This is called Wonderland. It has lovely flowers to practice your coloring skills and also it comes with lots of sentiments as well. And you can see the leaflet here to get some ideas on how you can put together your cards. And as always with all the new sets, there are also matching dies available. I'm stamping the largest of the flowers from the stamp set and I'm using black permanent ink for that to make sure that it's not going to smudge when I will use my alcohol markers to color it. Now I don't tend to overcolor with my alcohol markers. I always like to do some quick coloring and get this done. So I am showing you here a way of starting with the lightest color and moving all the way to the darkest and then back to the lightest one. Now this technique gives beautiful blending and great results, however I'm too impatient to do that for all the petals and that's why I'm using a super quicker method, which is I'm using the lightest color to apply color all over the petal and then I switch to the darker one and move to the middle and that's it. So here I'm going to show you again, I will use this lightest marker to color the entire petal. Then I will move on to the darker one and add the shadow at the base of my petal. And then I will use the 2 middle ones to just add some strokes. So notice that I am embracing those brush strokes and I don't overblend. I think it looks gorgeous as it is and a quick and easy coloring for me is the best. Now, of course, you can overwork it. You can end up with a beautiful and gorgeous ombre effect. Depends on the look you are going for really, but in any case the secret on good blending is to use colors that you know match together and this is great when you're using these sets because you know someone else did the hard work for you. And of course you need to use a paper which is made for these markers, for alcohol markers. In my case I'm using Nina Solar White 80 pounds cardstock. So I'm going to let you see how I color the whole flower. And as I'm doing that, I just want to let you know that this video today is actually part of a blog hop. If you go to my blog, you will find all the details about the blog hop. There is a ton of inspiration and lots of giveaways along the hop. So make sure to visit. You will find the link down below if you are watching on YouTube. You will also find there a full list of all the supplies that I'm using today to create my card. I will use for the stem colors from the same marker set, and since the area that I want to color is so thin, it gives me a great opportunity to use the fine tip nib from my marker. Now this is such a small area that you don't really need to do lots of in terms of shading. It's quick and simple here, I'll just mix a couple of colors. Now this would look gorgeous as a card, you need to stamp a sentiment that you are ready to go. However, I always like to have some dimension on my cards, I cannot go completely flat, so just had to use the matching dies to cut out the flower so that I can pop it later on my actual card. For my background, I'm going to stamp one of the designs from the block print stamp set, and for that I will go with one of the ink pads from the oval set that matches perfectly the colors of my markers, which means that I will be using the rose petal oval set, and the color I'm using is the lightest one, rose quartz, which is also the color of the lightest marker that I used. So now I have a background panel that matches perfectly the colors of my flower, and all I need to do is to add a sentiment. I cut out the word friend and I'm going to color it with my alcohol markers, and this is going to make sure that it's going to match nicely with the other colors on my card. Now I will not use the lightest color because this is the color of my background, and if I turn my sentiment the same color as my background, it is not going to pop up. So I am going to use the next three colors, and I'm going for an ombre look here, so I will try and add darker at the base and blend the colors out as I go towards the top. Once that was done, I cut out the same word one more time so that I can stack one on top of the other and end up with an element for my card that is nice and thick, and it is has more dimension. It's going to pop better on top of my card. Now another fun thing that you can do with these markers and the matching colors on ink pads is to stamp the sentiment. For that I'm using Lagoon, which is one of the colors that I used for the stems, and I'm stamping one of the sentiments from the same stamp set that says I appreciate your support. I'm going to cut it out to be a very thin strip of sentiment, and then it's time to put everything together on my card. I used foam squares at the back of the flower, but the bottom of the flower I'm going to stick it completely flat on my card. And here I had the idea to somehow combine the flower with the word, so I just threaded through that loop of the letter F. I'm going to stick it down, and now I can move up and down the word friend and decide where I want this to go. I'm going to leave the stem and the word, and I'm going to add some Nouveau de Luxe at the back. For now, only the actual petals are stuck on my panel, so it's time to stick everything else down. Of course, I added the little dot over the letter I, and I'm going to finish it off by sticking down the rest of my sentiment. Now, of course, you can take it a step further and add some sequins along the card, or even add some glitter over the word friend. I think it looks gorgeous as it is, so I decided to leave it plain and simple. So here are some close-up photos on the card. I hope you had fun and got inspired as I matched my alcohol markers with my inks today. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time.